Hello. As you can see, Rich could not be here tonight, so he asked me to cover for him. But to try to keep the format of his show as authentic as possible. So we're still going to be doing a bunch of giveaways from Rich's sponsors. Yeah, so Rich actually graciously made these graphics for me. And I just realized that my album art, I'm going to have to hide that because that's covering something. There we go. That's better. So yeah, Rich made all these and sent them to me late last night. So this way I could keep the vibe as much as possible. and I'll probably have Imah Fokker on when he gets home. Hopefully he'll be on soon. And if Joe is still around and wants to gab, he's more than welcome to come on as well. You know, so I can, hopefully he can come on and then maybe he can give something away and then maybe I can purge him and, you know, then he could post again and then I could purge him again and, you know, that all that fun stuff. Just kidding. yeah, some of you get the joke. If you follow the drama, that's too much. I watched that recording last night. I was just like, wow, really? Got to flex those mod muscles you do. Some people... Man, that was unbelievable. He's giving away a mod, not like, you know, a 10 mil of juice or something. The guy was giving away a mod. I mean, you know, a couple of posts is, I think, acceptable if the guy's gracious enough to give away a mod. Not a lot of people give away mods. You know, most people give out like 10 mil or 15 mil of juice, maybe a 30, you know, not a mod. Joe gives out mods with his own money. So... I don't know. I don't want to go on a rant here, but I just couldn't believe that happened, and I can't wait for Saturday. Should be interesting. But enough of that. So let me go over. Rich gave me a laundry list of stuff, so I'll probably have to do some. So yeah, I love Joe too. I've been lucky enough to hang out with Joe in person because we're both in Jersey. I look up to Joe, as I always like to say, literally, figuratively and literally. I think the angle is about, you know, like this or so. I'm like, hey, Joe, what's up, man? But yeah, Joe's good people, so I automatically get defensive. Can't help it. It's been nothing but a great guy to me. Choisy, yeah. Joe is more south, I'm more north, but we're in the same state, so, you know. Of course, Joe can't get out to many the vape meets because of Saturdays, but if a vape meet falls on a Friday, then it's likely that I can run into him. Yeah, let's see. I'll be over in my corner being oblivious. Nice frog. Oh, you're west? What part are you in, NJ1? Oh, let me get some music going. I knew something was missing. Anyway, let me see. Warren County. Okay. Yeah, I think, was it like upper, like Ski Mountain area? Like Shawnee, that area? Let's see. Well, first off, I might as well, since we were talking about spamming links, I'm just going to put a whole bunch of spam in here for Rich, since this is his slot and I'm covering for him. So here is all of his info, if it all makes it through. And it did. So that's all of Rich's stuff. Let's see. He does a winner's list that he always posts on his blog sometime between Friday, May 30th. Sometime on Friday, May 30th. And we'll retweet and post on Google Plus as well. Sorry, I'll be doing a lot of reading because he left me like a script. it will contain info on everyone who won tonight. The post will also contain specific instructions on how to claim your winnings. Please have your emails by 11:59 p.m. June 4th. This gives most of you the week to get your emails in. Any emails that come in after this time will be null and void. So that's from Rich. Oh, yeah. Or you could, yeah, you know, actually that works too. Pammy could just paste it and then I don't read it. That would be more efficient, wouldn't it? Yeah, I know, strawberry. You know what it is, strawberry? I'm very much very near. No, wait. Is it nearsighted when you? I can see stuff really well close, but super far away. Like, so when I'm driving and stuff, I wear glasses when I drive. But like, computer monitors, like, if I put glasses on right now at this distance, it would actually really bother my eyes. And obsolete saying it dropped. I still see it playing for me. Maybe refresh. What's up, Dougie? Dougie, did you get your juice today? Oh, cool. Joe said he might stop by. That'd be awesome. Love to have him. Dougie, I put a little something special on your bottle for you. Just my little way of messing with you. I hope you noticed. That was my way of messing with you. Because, you know, when you sent me a package and you used about a roll and a half of duct tape on it. Yeah, look at the bottle real closely. Towards the right side of the label. Surprised you missed it. Squinto-vision? Nice. Trifocals? Yeah, Jesus, Evil, you're making me feel older than I already feel. That's nice. I can increase my tech size, you know. All right, we'll flip it up one. Nice. There we go. Oh, see, it's like a little bigger now. How nice. Let's see. So, giveaways tonight. Just to do a summary. Kind of like a Nitro style summary. We've got one 30 mil bottle from Unicorn Vapors. For two winners, we have a code for a 15 mil bottle from BeeLiquid. So that's two winners, 15 mil each. Hooligan Vapes, we have two 10 mil bottles and 12 milligram nicotine only. So when we do that one, if 12 is too intense for you, you know, just piff it. Vaping Masters, we have three winners, 30 mil bottle each. And this is one I'm dying to try. River Bottom Fog Sauce, two winners, 130 ml bottle each. And from Timeless Vapor, our own Mandy Cat, $15 gift certificate. Oh, you saw it now, Dougie? You like? I just thought it'd be funny to throw something on your label. Yeah, you know, Suck My Vapor, this might sound weird, but I kind of have always believed, whether it's true or not, you know, it was up to the doctors, I guess, but I've always kind of felt that by not correcting my vision all the time, that it keeps my eyes from getting too lazy. Like, they always have to work, and it's, I guess I feel like it keeps it from getting worse. And it sort of worked for me because they've been the same my whole adult life. They haven't really progressed because I can tell because my glasses I wear when I drive, I mean, I can still read signs like, you know, really, really far away. So, I don't know. It's just weird. And that, and like I said, whenever I've ever tried to use them with a computer or anything close, like this close, it really looks blurry to me and it hurts my eyes a lot. So I just, you know, sometimes I might squint because like my notes that I'm looking at for, the note, the font's kind of small. I could probably boost that up too, actually. Sometimes I forget to do that. Let's see, what else? So I think I got all of the winners. And the only other thing that he mentioned, which I'm not sure how I'm going to pull this one off, but he wants to, for most of these, he's got it that he'd like it to be a newbie. Meaning that if you win it, he wants it, the winner to be someone that's never tried whatever the juice is. So I guess we'll just have to go on the honesty policy for that. So if you win and you've won that particular vendor before, especially if it was recently, you know, please piff it. I'm not sure. He had some personal stuff to do. So he asked me to... we ask in the room who's never had it in the paper. Pammy, are you just picking a name just just pick the person, or are you doing numbers, or how are you doing it? I mean, I'll follow whatever you guys normally do. I want to try to keep this authentic to Rich's format. Yeah, I know what you mean, Lou. That's kind of what I try to do. But I do have the bad habit of squinting sometimes. Like right now, I'm not squinting. But like if I'm not paying attention, I might squint because my vision gets razor sharp when I squint. Like, you know, you're changing the shape of your ball, and it like it's perfectly sharp when I do that. So sometimes I have the habit of doing it. Just pick the name. All right. Well, I don't know. Maybe, Pammy, maybe I'll have you do that because you're here more often than I am, probably on Thursdays, and so you might be good at perhaps identifying somewhat like a name that's not familiar to you or that you don't think has won that particular juice. That might be kind of fun to let you do that. Oh yeah, nice strawberry. Oh, so you do still like it, Dougie, well, and you haven't even let it steep yet. Yeah, that'll be fun. You want to do one now, Pammy? Just kick things off and reward the early attenders. And you want to go, since I'm coordinating with you, Pammy, you want to go at the bottom of the list he sent us. You want to go in the order that they're on the bottom there. So maybe start with Unicorn. Hey, Big Moose. This way we can fill in the form as we go. Oh yeah, and before I forget, Rich is big on the zip code thing, so just the last two digits of your zip code, if you do get chosen and you do want it and all of that good stuff, just put the last two of your zip, because I gotta type them in here and then send everything to Rich to do it. Nice, Dougie. You would love that, wouldn't you? All right, so Unicorn. So I do have some stuff to read, if you guys don't mind. Again, Rich is very organized, as you can tell, so I'm trying to be consistent here. So Will and Susan Thomas are from the Dallas metro area. They wanted to create high-quality e-liquids at prices that vapers can afford. Some of their best sellers include the Unicorn Custard, which is a vanilla custard, Blueberry Muffin, and Flamingo, which is peach, strawberry, and tropical fruits. That actually sounds really good. And Pammy put the links in. And that's Newbie Night. So he says, pick one person who has never tried this juice before. So I guess, Pammy, you're in charge. You want to have them rattle off their names if they've never tried Unicorn? And I'm gonna let Pammy do this. And maybe Pammy, if it's easier, do you want to have them all type the same thing, like me or one, or it might make it easier to spot. So I would say, I don't know, guys, you decide, but let's make it consistent. All right, it doesn't matter. All right, it's Pammy, as long as you can spot them easily. I was just trying to make it easier to visually identify. I guess ones or me's or boing, K-Springs. Looks like most of you haven't. I haven't seen too many people say they have. Raul Giuliani, you were killing me last night. You had some good one-liners. I forget one of the ones you posted I thought was really funny. So, let's have the winners do the last two of the zip. I think Pammy, I think this one is just one. That's what he has in the notes at the bottom, unless he put something else. Yeah, it's just one winner. $49. Okay. Let me get that in there. Got it. Good. We got that one done. Cool. Okay, you want Pammy, you want to just do that? You, well, let's see what the next one is. Make sure that BBH hasn't had that one before. So, we might as well go into the second one. All right, so the next one up is BeeLiquid. We have two winners. It's going to be a code good for 115 mil bottle each, including shipping. So it's going to be two winners, 15 mils a piece, and it's going to be a code. So Pammy, if you want to make BBH one of them, if you've never had that one, and then Pammy, maybe we could pick one other one. And this is the same thing Rich has, newbie night, so he wants to make it someone that's never had it. So I'm cool with, yep, so let's give Pammy a sec. So BVH never had it, so that'll be the one, so we just got to pick one more. Schwitty. Schwitty Bulls. That's a great skit. What's up? Actually, Dougie, that's one sheet. It's packing paper, and it's made from, you want to see it? I'll show you what I used. show and tell with your host. It's made out of recycled newspaper, actually. So they, I guess they do something to the newspaper. They clean it all up. I guess they get as much ink out of it as possible. And so it's either that or peanuts. I got to take that space up somehow. And I know most of you guys probably hate the peanuts. So I've been using that paper. It only takes one sheet to pretty much fill the empty space in most exactly, that's why I use the paper. It's one sheet. When you unfold the whole thing, it's one sheet that you can just throw away if you want. Or recycle.
Do you like his music?
No.
Alright, Zodic is the winner. So, let's get the last two of the zip on that one. Okay, that'll work. And BVH, what was yours? I don't remember if you put it before. Last two, just the last two of the zip, just so I can put it in Rich's notes. I like the song, it's pretty funny. Let's see. BBH, did you do your last two? Ah, oh, there we go, 92. Okay, awesome. Thank you. All right, so far, so good. Hopefully I won't screw up this file. So So I had a topic I wanted to, I thought would be fun to talk about for a minute. How many of you guys have messed around with any of these new high wattage? Oh yeah, let's let everybody read that from Pammy, and then I'll get into it. Thank you, Dougie. I do too, actually. So that's nice. The two of us agree. So, topic. How many of you guys have messed around or have bought any of these new generation high wattage mods / chips out of China? So that would be like a 722 or a 730, or the Chinese the China Hanamod clone. Now the Tobiko 30 watts coming out. There's like, you know, just a whole slew of them. Just curious if anyone has played around with any of them at all and what your experience has been. I mean, I could speak to the 722, but I'm curious to see what if anyone else has messed around with any of these and what you think about them, and especially if you've got one. That GI tube board, yeah, that thing looks sick. You got to handle it. How was it, Dougie? Did it? I mean, was it built well, or like was it a all hot glue inside, or like what was it like? Yeah, I can speak to the 722, and you know my wife has it, and I can't say anything bad about that. It is built like a friggin' tank. It is heavy. If anything, that's the only bad thing you could say, if that even bothers you. Because to me, it's kind of a sign of how well built it is. It is heavy. I mean, you hold it in your hand and you just look at it like, I can't believe this is that heavy for how the size that it is. You could tell a difference between that. Yeah, that's kind of what I was afraid of. See, what I'm really curious about, and what I'm kind of why I brought the subject up, is like that Tobiko that's coming out. I saw two. There's Tobiko one that's coming out that's a 30 watt, and then there's Vamos. What's that company? Starts with a K. They're putting out a 22 and a 30 watt Vamo. And I'm wondering how KSD. Thank you, Aussie. And I'm wondering, how are those chips? Are those the same type of chips, like SX chips, like in 722s, or is it some completely different factory making those chips? And are those chips any good, or are they not good? That's what I'm wondering. Chris, I haven't tried to push it super, super low. I thought I read somewhere that it could go to like 0.4, but to me, I never try to use variables that way. I tend to do the opposite with them. I tend to like throw extra wraps in my coils and try to take advantage of the fact that I have the chance to push past 4.2 volts. You know what I mean? Because like on a mech, you're kind of stuck with that. So you got 4.2 volts, and then you're lowering and lowering your resistance to get the wattage up. With a device like this, you can go past 4.2. You can go 5 volts. You can go 6 volts. So I tend to throw extra wraps in and try to create more surface area with the juice. Yeah, 8.1 volts. Yeah, that vicious ant looks sick. I like the screen on that thing. It looks pretty awesome. Has anyone messed with one of those in person? Mad Vapist, did you get to play with one? I just thought this would be a good topic because, I mean, they're just flying out of China now. And to me, they're kind of, you know, making me rethink the whole mech thing, right? Like, I did like most of you guys, you know, like the normal journey, ego style, and then I, you know, started messing around with mechs with like an IGOL and that kind of thing, and obviously it's way more power. And now I'm sort of getting interested in this regulated volt, you know, vaping again, because the wattages are going up. I mean, I've had this guy for a while. You know, DNA 20, this is the old Vapor Shark, and you know, it's been pretty awesome. Although, you guys want to see something kind of neat? Every once in a while, at least the DNA 20 does, it actually kind of locks up, or it gets confused. And mine is in that state right now. And the only way to fix that is either open it up and disconnect the power, which is a real pain in the butt to do, Or you just basically have to vape it down until the battery's dead so it'll reset. So I want to show you what that looks like. So let's see, which way are we going? Might be easier with the close-up cam. So if I hit up or down, so you notice the V is just like got no numbers. And I'm hitting up and down and the wattage isn't changing. It's like basically frozen, although what's interesting is that it'll still fire. So it'll fire, I can vape it. But it's completely locked up. Like, it's not showing the voltage at all. I wish they should have like a reset. No, it's not in lock mode because I can vape it. You see, I just vaped it, watch. See, it's firing, but this it's locked. Matter of fact, the screen isn't changing. It's stuck on 14.3 watts, but what I haven't tried is it might actually be going up and down. I can't tell if it is. But this is also the older DNA 20 chip, not the newer 30, and I know there's some changes in the logic and the way that they work. But this is the second time I've ever had to do this. So basically, I'm just gonna have to vape it. And then when it gets really low, I'll just keep firing it until it gets so low, it'll reset. And then the screen will be fine again. Oh, sorry. Whoops. I forgot. Sometimes when I switch the scene, then I look away from XSplit and I forget to switch it back. Because most of the time I'm looking at the chat. Yeah, no, this ego, it's not a feature of the DNA 20. I actually wish it did that, but let me see what happens if I try the lock. So if I do the lock thing, all it's doing is dimming and brightening the screen. This is weird. Hi, ego. I'm so, you know I'm like ADD'd out. You should know that by now. Yeah, see, it turns on and off, but that's it. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's the mirror image of myself. I figured I'd hang out with myself. I'm schizophrenic and so am I. So yeah. You know, that might work actually. Let me see if that works. Which way would I have to go? I'd have to go this way and then like lean in. Hey. Yeah, I just hang out with myself. Music, sizzling barbecues, baseball games, and more. Yeah, that just happened now. Oh, I'm not right in the head, I tell you. But that's what some of you hopefully like about me, because I'm a little warped.
Don't listen to him. He's not quite right in the head.
Let's see. Oh, so we were talking about wattage mods. So, I don't know. Any that GI2? Yeah, that thing would be sick. Yeah, but Dougie, it works in my favor too, because when I concentrate on one thing, I can concentrate really well on one thing, just one thing only. You remember DOS? I'm DOS as a person. I am DOS. I run one app. And one run app. And then if you want to do something else, you got to close that app. You got to close it. Then you can run another app for a while. That's how I work. No Windows here. Yeah, I'm command line. And not even Linux command line, which could be, you know, multi-threaded. I am just like one thing. But I can do it really well, I tell you. When I concentrate on something, I can go pretty deep. Crash all the time. Yeah, I do have a crash once in a while. No, I don't. I don't run my computers like that. My brain runs like that, ego. My computers. I got a million Windows. I finally have multi-monitor now. It's awesome. I can finally, run this show properly. I was trying to do it all on one monitor, and that was really hard to do. Yeah, right, Dougie? You understand what I was saying? Well, thank you, Eagle. All right, let's do we'll do another giveaway. I hate waiting till the end for all the giveaways, and then I run out of time. So let's see who's next on the list. Hooligan Vapes. We haven't done that one yet. And let's see what Rich has for that. Let's see. This is like a book Rich left me. Oh, where is it? Here we go. I found it. It was on page like 29. Yeah, well, Ego's got that slightly twisted perception on things, which I like about her, actually. If you give her even the tiniest little thing to mess with, she's going after it. You can count on that. All right, let's see. One winner. Wait, that's confusing. One winner, two 10 mil. Oh, maybe one winner gets both bottles. Two by 10 mil bottles. Viewer's choice of flavors. Nick will only be. Oh, this is the one that's. Nick is fixed at 12 milligram. No, Dougie. I have a gig tomorrow night in Bayonne, New Jersey, of all places. So if anyone's anywhere near Bayonne, please come out and see my band. Let's see. Intro. Case Orion, one of the most giving vendors I've ever seen. They truly are vapors first and vendors second. They broadcast together Saturday night, 8 to 10 on Quest. Case also does a Monday, Wednesday, Friday AM show and a show 8 to 10 PM with Raider Chick called Gridiron Vaping. Also famous for the famous drip tips of our life that can be found here. And I will paste the link. So let me just confirm that is. Pammy, would you know on this one? It is one winner, and that one winner gets both 10 mil bottles. It just seems kind of strange, but maybe that's how they run that. Just wondering what you think, or if you remember from previous weeks. Piff to immutable. What I love about Ego's show is the booby stretches, you know, because you get to drink when she does that, and she does it a lot. That's part of the drinking rules. Oh, it is one winner. Okay. And that's also a newbie night one. So we'll run it the same way. So someone that's never tried it before. Why don't you guys rattle off either a one or a no if you've never had it before and you want Pammy to consider you in her random selection. Oh yeah, there are, Ego. I see you do that stretch all the time. I'm an expert. I know how to spot them. If you've seen my wife, you know why, and that's all I'll say. Oh, Ego, thank you so much. You're not too hard on the eyes either there, Ego, so right back at you. Yeah, she's quite the character. That's one of the... I've always joked around that I think humor is what's made us last so long. I mean, we're going on 20 years of dating and almost over 10 years of marriage, so... I think the humor has been the secret ingredient. No, that's not true, Ego. Lately, I'm like, I don't know. My wife and I joke about this. We're both like suddenly got lame. I don't remember when it happened, but I don't drink that much anymore. Just once in a blue moon. I mean, I'll have some drinks, but I don't drink like I used to. I think as I've gotten older, the hangovers have gotten to be too unforgiving. Yes, Rich does look a little different this week. Mm-hmm. Oh, nice, Dougie. That's the last time I send you butterscotch custard. Yeah, so very similar, you go. Like, very, very similar time. Yeah, the humor is what gets you through, I swear. If you can make each other laugh, that's, I'm telling you, you're onto something. Yeah, Lou, you know, you're right about that. It really is dead true, Lou. And I used to do a thing I called Hangover Helper, which is basically right before bed, I'd take, like, Hangover Helper or Hamburger Helper, but it's Hangover Helper, and it's 2 Advil or 3 Advil and as much water as you can humanly stand, and it helps, but you still feel it, you know? But yeah, I mean, hydrating is one of the tricks for sure. But I mean, as long as I don't go nuts, it's fine. But if I go crazy like I used to, I pay for it dearly. But you're right. It's very smart to do it while you're doing it instead of at the end, like I usually typically do. All right, let me, I gotta look up at the numbers and concur. Do you concur? No, I concur. Do you concur? I concur. Anyone see that movie? I love that line. I should have concurred. Yep, I concur, Pammy. Name the movie if you know what movie I'm doing. Do you concur? I concur. Do you concur? I concur. No one? No one knows that movie? There you go. The juice sheen, he got it. That's an awesome scene. And then afterwards, the doctor's all mad at himself. He's like, I should have concurred. Deadmau5, or Deadmau5, depending on how you like to say it. right this second. Pretty cool, actually. Yeah, totally immutable. That's why it's funny in the movie, because of the way they use it, the way he does it in the movie, because he knows, has no idea. He's trying to be pretend like he's a doctor, and he knows nothing about medicine, so he's just trying to sound smart, and the two real doctors on either side are, he's like, do you concur? And they're like, I concur. Matt Vapist, I'm actually running a iTunes radio channel based off of Skrillex, so it just picks stuff in that vein. I'm good, TX. How you doing? Why didn't I just concur? Exactly. That scene is great. If you haven't seen that movie, you got to check it out. It's definitely recommend. It's a good movie. Good old Leo. That the Academy will always diss him because he's too good looking. So, you know, they like to diss people because they're jealous instead of giving them credit for being talented. What's up? Oh, we were talking about Catch Me If You Can with Leonardo DiCaprio, Tom Hanks were in that. It's older. It came out a while ago, but it was really, really funny. It's a good movie. That's when I started saying concur. It made me think of it. You can't think of that word without thinking of that movie. Oh, and since I'm not paying attention again, which is really surprising, NJ1 Fun Guy, did you put in your zip? I haven't seen it yet. Oh, you, Pammy, are you keeping track of all of these, like writing them down for Rich? In which case, I'll stop trying to type and hit save every 2 seconds. I guess we both don't have to do it, and you're probably better at it than I am. Okay, we got it here. And that was the one that was 12. Oh, so you do that, Pammy? That's great. I mean, if you're doing it, your list will probably be more organized than mine. I just want to make sure I have, you know, that one of us has something to give Rich so that it's not a letdown for him. Yeah, I know, Dougie. I'm actually trying to, like, keep track of things as much as humanly possible. Or scopingly possible, which is different than humanly possible. So what else? Where the hell's Fokker? Usually we would be gabbing about now. Oh, he compares it to? Okay, well, I'll keep going then, Pammy. So, because I've got everything so far. We still have 3 winners for Vaping Masters, we still have River Bottom, and we still have Timeless to go. So we're doing pretty good. Y'all. I still love the Tony's accent the best. His accent just, you can't beat that accent or that stash, really. Where is the Tony? We got to get him on here. Yeah, we need the Tony. Because then, you know, we need him to give away his Tesla mod. Because apparently he's the only person in the universe that has a Tesla mod, which I didn't know there was such a thing as. Tesla, and the rest of us wrap coils. He wraps coals. I didn't know you could wrap coal. I thought it was used as a form of generating energy a long time ago, but I guess he actually can wrap them somehow. Wraps coals on his Tesla. What else does he say? You should, Dougie. That would be awesome, the Tesla. Put like some crazy logo with like electricity shooting, like the word Tesla in the middle with like lightning bolts coming out of it, and then I don't know, we gotta send a picture of it to him and say, this is the real Tesla, you have a fake, and get him all riled up. Ow, that is rough, ego. Ouch. Isn't that same picture they put Nitro's face on? Mmm. Mad Vapist, that would actually be the right way to do that, would be something along these lines. Either this, Tesla Cole, or you could do like this, a Tesla Cole. But that, it's definitely a Cole. Or perhaps you could get an H in there somewhere, because it kind of extends out a little bit. You need something to show the length. Cole. Oh, now that's just scary. Oh, that's just so wrong. Nitro always is the brunt of all the Photoshop brain bleach. Yeah, need some of that. Cole, you want it? Yeah, gotta love the you want it. My favorite, he still hasn't beat the one show that was my favorite ever, was the night, I don't know if you guys know her, but and she's probably not anymore, but she, her handle is a noob vapor, like a noob vapor. And she won on Tony's show, and he, you know, he was getting aggravated with everybody because people weren't responding fast enough, and he's like, a knob viper, you want it? And I've been calling her a knob ever since. Yeah, that was classic. That one and the night that Mandy was on, and we finally got the truth about the cats and why he always calls her a cat killer. That was a pretty legendary show. Was anyone here for that one? I haven't seen Anoob in a while. Kind of miss Anoob. I haven't seen her in chat in a while. I guess we're two ships passing in the night. Yeah, exactly, Dougie. That night, I swear, I was the hardest I've laughed in about 3 years. I don't know. Somehow we started just going on and on about the deep fryer, and we were saying that the cat, you know, didn't just commit suicide in the deep fryer, that he actually did a swan dive into the deep fryer. And then I started picturing the cat like doing a run and jump and like throwing the paws out like this. Oh, it's just terrible. How does a cat fall into a deep fryer that happens to be on? I'm just asking. Yeah, the first Stash Show, TX, totally agree with you there. The first time we all got to see that, yeah, very dumb cat is right. Don't they sense heat normally? I mean, cats are pretty smart. They kind of sense, like, food that's bad for them, things that are hot, and spaces that are too tight. Although they do the shit with the trees, right? They climb trees and they can't get down, so I guess they do have their mistakes. But, yeah, or help from a dog. Yeah, the dog is probably like, watch, you chase him this way, I'll chase him that way. Oh. Who's that? We have a mystery guest. This will be good. Well, who the hell are you? All right, so we all have to try to figure out who this guest is. And let me fix that. Who could that be knocking at my door? Is that damn Fokker guy? Is that my co-host? I can't even tell. Well, I bet the only way to flush him out will be to with voices. You know, like if I were to arbitrarily just say, I'd like a large pie, fry, medium coffee. You got that good, buddy? Large pie, fry, medium coffee. Pronto.
I am the great Canorio. I need to be for me bunghole.
My bungholio has polio. Mm-hmm.
Are you threatening me?
Are you threatening me? I need more cappuccino for my bunghole.
Mm-hmm. Oh boy, here we go. So, where did you get that lovely... Oh, you can vape through it? That's good. That just doesn't look right at all. Stealth vapor, yeah.
Yeah, it works a little bit.
Did you actually make a hole for vaping, or are you just kind of
sucking
actually it through
the phone? It's actually got a mesh right here through the eyes and where the mouth is, so I can actually get through it.
Oh, nice. Stealth is a grenade. That's nice. Stealth vapor. I like that. Hey, Purple Easy.
Darth Vapor, huh?
Or Darth Vapor. That works. Well, I'm Tower. I'm Tower of Scope tonight. So
the Tower of Scope.
Yeah.
Okay. Enough of this. I'm hot. Mm.
If you have an apple in your mouth, I'm going to be very upset with you. Just saying. Okay. Good. I thought you were going to be like the Gimp in Pulp Fiction or something, and you're just going to be like one of those balls with the strap.
So what's going on tonight, man? I tell you what, Gold's Gym just about kicked my ass today.
Oh, snap.
Oh, I can barely lift my arms right now.
Ah, so what's going on? I'm glad you could make it.
Oh, nothing much. What's going on? What's been going on in the room? Has it been lively since I've been gone?
Somewhat. We did a few giveaways. We're trying to stick to Rich's format as much as possible.
Asking questions. So I get to come up with trivia now that we can come out with later for people to actually try to find out if they can win?
Well, what we've been doing, so Rich Rich put a little extra sort of thing. I think he does this like once a month. He does like, it's like, he calls it newbie night.
Newbie night.
And so what he likes to do is he likes to limit the winners to people that have never had whatever that juice is before.
Well, see, that's one thing I like about what he does his giveaways. It's not just random. It's, hey, you've had this before. Who hasn't? And that's the way it should be.
Yeah.
That's absolutely the way it should be. As a matter of fact, that's something I try to do, even if it's something I love. If I've won something from a vendor before, I will pivot to somebody that hasn't had it, because that's the whole point of these vendors giving stuff away, is they want people to try it. And guess what? If I like it, I'm going to come back and buy it. So I don't need to get the free stuff anymore.
Yeah, well, a few of you guys might know that I make juice too. And
no way.
I actually do, yeah.
Oh my gosh, I never knew this, and I've been co-hosting with you for a couple weeks. What the heck is going on here? Oh, man.
I make this little thing called Angelic that, you know, a couple people like. And yeah, that's absolutely true. And in my
hopefully
case...
Hopefully by next week, I'll do my own review on the Angelic.
Yeah, that'd be cool. I would appreciate that.
Well, I've been winning juice on Vapors TV, and I keep telling myself I need to start up a YouTube channel and just do my own reviews, which are probably going to be horrible, but I don't care. I'm going to do them, and I'm going to do my best to link them to the sites that I want them from. So, you know, hey, that's like the least I can do, right?
To answer Shot in the Jaw, I have. Those of you guys that know me know that I'm kind of weird with vaping, in the sense that most of the stuff I vape is more beverages, but my wife does more like the dessert vapes. She really liked the Quacks quite a bit, because that's more her profile. Again, it's not really my flavor profile, but it's good. It's just I tend to like, I don't vape desserts very often, or things that are even... I'm weird. Like, I like tart stuff, like sodas and lemonades.
Here's
and teas
the gizzard.
And,
yeah. I've got the gizzard too.
Yeah, I have one of those. I got a little bottle of that one. Mm-hmm. I think I have a
the frozen pond.
I haven't tried that one yet.
I can't do the menthol. It's not a heavy menthol, but it's still a little bit too much menthol for me. That's just a personal taste.
Well, also so, too, yeah, and also yeah. You got to keep in mind what you're vaping it in, right? Like, because. You know, dual coils, dripper, you know, lower ohms tends to bring out every little nuance in a juice. So what might have been intended, you know, say the maker of the juice was, you know, testing in, you know, more like, you know, normal devices where it's like a hint of menthol at 0.3 ohms becomes suddenly a lot of menthol. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
And
like
things
that are a lot
hint to do with it as well. But it's for me, there's been like one menthol juice that I've actually been able to like, and it's like the ever so slightest amount of menthol. I don't know how they barely put that in, but other than that, it's like, even though, and I will say, frozen pond is not a heavy menthol. It is not, but it's just a tad bit too much for my personal taste. That's about it. But the same thing, goose juice, which frozen pond, from what I understand, is pretty much goose juice with a little bit of menthol. Is yeah, but I have a couple of new juice. I got some vape mail in today that I gotta start getting used to. So, and then I gotta wait for some vape mail from Scope too. So we'll talk about Angelic next week, because I'm gonna do a side by side comparison of the Angelic and the Mother's Milk that I still have left over.
Oh, nice. That'd be cool.
Yeah, well, the difference is I'm going to sub-ohm yours.
Awesome.
Well, that's what I've been hearing. I don't know, because there's a lot of people that talk about how yours, and this is just from what I've heard, that the Angelic Custard is like a mother's milk that you can sub-ohm. And it is very true for me, I think. I really have only put my Suicide Bunny in my K-Fund because I have it built at a 1-ohm coil right now, which... hits perfectly. It doesn't, you know, I don't have any crazy taste with it. I get a lot of good flavor, but I have tried it on my Arachi, my Patriot, which right now I have set up to about a 0.25 ohm nano coil, and it you will start changing the flavor in it when you go that low.
Yeah.
Oh wait! Toxic Angel is in the house. All right, hold on. I got mango cupcake, and Booberry in from Toxic today, and she also gave me a free awesome sauce to be able to try out. Eventually, I guess I'll get some Bitchberry from her as well. I'm waiting on the Bitchberry too, because that one sounds really, really cool. But she came into a room and just so happened to impromptu do a juice giveaway, and that's where I got the Bitchberry. But this is how great Angel is. I went out and paid for these because she had another thing going on, and I remembered that, and I said, you know what, I'm going to buy some and try this out. I kind of figured Toxic, but what I'm trying to say is she takes care of the people that pay first, because I ordered this probably about 3 days after I won, and I got this before my winnings. So she takes care of the paying customers. So, you know, I don't know if she's got any more coupons out there, but I haven't had a chance to try it yet, Toxic, but I will definitely let you know after I have a chance.
Purple Nemesis Lube. I didn't know, did they sell that in the adult stores? I haven't seen that yet.
Oh, you want the cream of some young guy.
Oh, you'll be here you'll 4 hours.
You'll go now. You've been here 4 hours.
You'll be here 4 hours. You know, bye. You go. We don't like all kind.
I love what... Oh man, someone wrote something in Skype the other day that was really funny. It was like one of the best like spams of you know how they spam, like they even spam, like I get sometimes Chinese vendors will go on scopejuice.com and they have to type the captcha, cuz you know I have a captcha on there to email me. They take the time and type the captcha and then spam me with, "We make the most excellent flavor." Very good burnt taste.
No burnt taste.
Sometimes they'll say very good burnt taste.
You vape long time.
You vape long time, no burnt taste. I get
and
them.
And I'm
all
sorry, everybody. I haven't eaten all day, so I'm going to eat a little bit here, too. But I'll still be talking.
Me vape
I'll
you long.
I'll wipe my mic off when I'm done.
Oh, yeah. Number one e-liquid from Shenzhen. They always say that, too.
Number one e-liquid from Shenzhen.
Number one.
Oh, you're not number one. You're number 10.
I actually saw no burnt taste once for a drip tip, and I was like, how did they pull that off? That I got to
no
buy that.
No burnt taste for a drip tip?
Yeah, a magic drip tip that somehow you could, you don't have to put juice in it. You could just burn cotton, but somehow the tip is going to magically make it not burnt. Like that, you'll save so much money on juice. You just sit there and burn your wick.
Burn cotton. Cotton cheaper than juice. Oh, you get no burnt taste.
No burnt taste. Excellent drip tip. Great flavor.
You just need to add nicotine.
Number one drip tip in Shenzhen.
Oh, gosh.
Immutable. Honestly, I don't think there is anything better than a really well-made cheesesteak. It's the perfect food.
But yeah, my cheesesteak is a Five Guys bacon cheeseburger right now.
Ooh, that sounds pretty good. They make a mighty good burger.
Ah, yes. That's right.
Me vaping now,
unfortunately, I think I just pounded too many peanuts before I even got my food.
Nice. What was I going to ask you about? Love Five Guys.
Squirrel!
Squirrel! Yeah, I totally just did squirrel. If anyone hasn't seen that scene in the movie Up, it's like, that's me. I'm that dog. Squirrel!
Hi, I like you. What's your... Squirrel! Okay, let me see if I can find something to put up here in the meantime while I eat, because I don't want to see... I don't want y'all seeing me eat. Okay, that'll work. For now.
Calzones are better? But yeah, calzones can be pretty good. Oh, really? I tell you, I actually can remember the, like, one in... You know, you have like a few moments in your life, like where you eat something that's so good that you have, it's almost, I hate to use the word, but there's no other word, like that orgasmic.
I was thinking the same word. I was like, is he not going to say orgasmic? Yeah.
Well, there's no other word. So I remember one time in my drum tech days, I was on tour with somebody, I don't remember who, probably could have been Anthrax or Living Color or something, and we happened to be doing a show in Philly, and this was years ago, like early 90s, And somebody, I know there's like two famous ones in Philly. Like,
and they're
two,
like across the street.
Yeah,
from
they're like, I think, yeah, I think they're like diagonally across. And someone went on a run and got those. And I tell you, after doing a loadout, and if anyone knows what I mean by a loadout, it's like when you break down a stage, you do like 4 hours worth of work in about 15 minutes. It's just go time. Like you work because it's all like time is money. You know what I mean? You have to, drums got to come down instantly, then the sound, then the lights got to come down.
Right.
Everything has to get into the semi as fast as humanly possible. So you work really hard. And after doing that, someone handed me one of these cheesesteaks from Pat. Yeah, it was either one of those two.
One or the other.
I tell you, at like 3 a.m, I took a bite of that thing. I can still remember it to this day. Like, obviously, I could tell the story. That's how amazing it was. Like, it was like the most perfect food I ever ate. Maybe it was something to do with being 3 a.m. and after a loadout. That probably played into it. But, wow. I mean, I can't even begin to tell you how good it was. So if you're ever in the Philly area, you got to try those two. I wish I could tell you which one it was. I don't know. I know it was one of the two big ones.
Let's see if I can get that somewhere there again.
They should. Obviously, doesn't know what a cheesesteak is. Is that really true? Obviously, please tell me. She's serious. Obviously, doesn't know what a cheesesteak is. Wow.
What?
Wow.
Come on. I mean, we call you Obs, and I still think Obs. Every time somebody says that, I think of my character from Eve because his name is Obsequious, and nobody could pronounce it, so they always call him Obs. So every time somebody says Obs, now I'm getting used to Obsolete. I mean, come on. But you don't know what a cheesesteak is?
Here, let's see.
You gotta have a real, real shaved beef makes it the best. Not that steak-em stuff. If you get some real shaved beef, you'll just be like, that's about all I have to say about that.
There's a cheesesteak. That's actually a picture of a Geno's one, apparently. it's so how they do it. They like, you know, if you look at that one, it looks like actual real steak that's super, super thin. And then they, you know, the cheese, and then a lot of times they do like little onions on it.
You can get caramelized onions. You can put the mushrooms on it. You can get peppers grilled. I mean, it really depends on how you like it. No, I don't think we say anything about shaved beaver. I did say shaved beef.
Otherwise known as a hardwood floor, what?
Yeah, you know what Ted Williams says, if there's grass on the field, let's play ball.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if anyone... does anyone know who Opie and Anthony are? This is total local... Well, not local
anymore.
Actually,
they're on XM as well.
Yeah, so if anyone knows who they are, I listened to them for a long time because they were in the, well, first they were in Boston. They got kicked off the air because they played a joke saying the mayor, Menino, was dead. So they got thrown off the air for that. Then they were in New York City. They got thrown off the air because a couple was playing a game where they got points for having sex in public places, and one of the couples happened to pick St. Pat's Cathedral, which is kind of a big no-no in New York City to do something like that. So I got kicked off the air there, and then they went on XM. But anyway, the reason I brought
them up... I thought it was a ginger joke because I've been called Opie so much in my life. I figured that's where you were going at, so please proceed.
But anyway, so you just totally reminded me of something. I don't know how much of this I can get away with
if
saying.
If I hear the Andy Griffith song, I'm going to go ballistic.
But they used to do a game called Guess What's in My Pants. And they would have, you know, people call in to the show. And then basically they would take the phone, the part you talk into, and they would have to go rub up and down and then side to side, and then the sound that it made, you would have to guess the pattern, if you will. I'm speaking in code here.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the options was a hardwood floor. Anyway, you guys just totally made me think of that.
Was one of them called Shag Carpet?
I don't think so. I think there was only like four choices to make the game like a little bit so you had a chance to win. But it was pretty funny.
Shag Carpet, Hardwood Floor, Racing Stripe.
Yeah, they definitely, I think they called it a run, something runway or whatnot. Yeah, it was funny though. They did some really amazing stuff on that show. Like, some of it was definitely over the top, but
I think that's the reason why they went to XM.
Yeah, yeah, so they could get away with it. Well, Anthony, that's kind of why I like you, is you remind me of Anthony a little bit in the sense.
Oh, thank God I don't remind you of Opie. Okay, I like you a lot better, Skip. I will be back on Tuesday now.
Yeah, well, if you think about their formula. You know, to make the comparison, their formula, which always seemed to work, is like Opie was like the idea guy. Like, he was always the one trying to like decide what they were going to do next and stuff. And but Anthony was the one doing all the voices and everything. And
taking it to the next level.
Yeah. But, yeah, I was trying to tiptoe a little bit. I don't want to be too.
Yeah, they have a quasi cheesesteak at Subway. It's not really a cheesesteak, but that's what they call it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's very. I
agree with Immutable. I've had them. They're okay. It's not like getting a real cheesesteak.
It's not to say I wouldn't eat one, but it's not something I would. It's more like a steak and cheese. It's not a cheesesteak. It's all wheel drive and all out fun handling.
I'm looking at the I Saw a Squirrel video because I'm being a squirrel and looking at it. Or chasing the squirrel by following.
I'm trying to scarf down this friggin' food.
And it won't load for some reason. All right, let me try refreshing it. I Saw a Squirrel. It won't play.
All right, two more bites.
Hurry, girl. What did you learn?
I saw a squirrel.
Oh, there it is. Okay, cool.
What are you talking about, Toxic? You got a version of plain custard?
Yeah, it sounds. Yeah, I do something very, very similar.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was looking at it. You've got what? Blueberry, raspberry, strawberry, and butterscotch to be able to add to the custard flavor.
Yeah, strawberry too. Did you say strawberry?
Yes, I think I said strawberry.
Strawberry, blueberry, butterscotch, peach, and raspberry. Yeah, those are the five.
Oh, peach. I miss peach. That's
yeah,
what I miss.
Peach is in there too. Could peach really be more. I could, honestly, I could probably do just throw just about anything in there. There's like, I like to think of it as like a pocket for that accent flavor that you can fill.
Mm-hmm.
So
what is it? Is it like a basic vanilla custard or just a basic custard that you add to it?
It's basically the rest of the ingredients are all for what make the custard flavor, and then
okay.
There's this like spot reserved for the accent. I call it the accent flavor. So
all right, so this is what I want y'all to do. Come up onto Scope site, and when you look at the angelic custard, when you go to the checkout in the extra comments, see if you can come up and say, "Wouldn't mind seeing this flavor added," and he might actually say, Let me think about that. And he'll probably do a couple beta tests, and then you might see it pop up on the site.
I got about 120 or so flavors, so chances are I might be able to do it, unless you really pull something out of left field.
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't think you want to put crab custard on there.
Yeah, like no crab flavoring. Mango, I think I could do. I think I have mango. I have to go look at my mango collection.
I never
thought of that,
of mango.
Pammy, and that would be good.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on, now I gotta look. Entertain the crowd.
See what we started. Uh oh. Let's see: dragon fruit, mango, mamgo. I don't know what mamgo is, but.
Somehow I have two identical vials of mango.
Yeah, hey, they're really pretty. Giuliani has a perfect one, man. We're going to make a cheesesteak custard.
That is a good idea, Pammy. Right on. I like that. That might have to be the next one.
Gurr? Oh my gosh. Okay, well, let me see if I can pull up some Gurr and I'll listen to it and I'll see if I can do something, because that's from Invader Zim. Is Gurr from Invader Zim?
And Dragon Fruit. I could do that too. I have Dragon Fruit. Coconut? I could do that. Yeah, I didn't even think of that. If I put coconut flavor, yeah, there's so many custards I could do.
Yeah,
I don't know why I haven't just added them all in. I don't know. I've just been like slow and I add one, I wait a while. I add another one, I wait a while. I could do Nana. Yeah, I could do that too. You know, honestly, you could just, what I should just do is put create your own and say write it in the notes, and then, you know, unless I think I can't do it, in which case I would email you back and say, oh, I don't have that one. Can I give you this one or this one instead or something like that?
Right. Well, I mean, I think that's a great little thing. Is you know, eventually you probably can come up with like a contest. You know, who comes up with the one that I like the best?
Hey Lou, I'm down with that if you want to do something like that. I'll fucking take it to a yoga ashram and shit. If anything, I'm on kind of a tea kick lately. I don't know why, but I don't know. I've been really digging teas lately. Peanut butter custard, that would be fun.
I gotta find a Gurr soundboard.
I have stuff for chai too. I haven't played with chai in a while. I have the flavoring for it. I need to re-explore that.
Oh no, I can't do that. I'm trying to pull up a Gurr soundboard for Android on my PC. That ain't gonna work. Let's see. Gurr Wave. Let's see if I can get something.
Yeah, so Obsolete's really interesting. So she actually really likes Angelic, but only when it's fresh. Because she, I guess to her, it tastes less custardy and more something else. Obsolete, put it into words.
Probably more like creamy than custardy.
Yeah, does it taste more like a cream to you, like a vanilla cream or a strawberry cream?
Yeah, because the custard starts getting more like a custard as it steeps, but it's like more of that creamy taste when you get it right out.
Yeah,
I don't know if I could do Gurr. That sounds like a hard one. Yeah, I'll have to practice that one if you want to hear Gurr.
That's a great question. D-Millen, let me think about that. The worst, like couldn't vape it. You mean aside from my famous machine oil K-Fun?
Oh, did you finally dunk
but
that?
I don't get credit for this mix. This is all the K-Fun doing it. It started off as normal juice, and the machine oil made it something else. Let me try it again, see how much machine oil I taste tonight. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I can't finally lose
this. Yeah, that's machine oil.
Oh, you haven't done anything with it? You still haven't dumped it out.
That's,
you said you're
going
to dump
list.
It out.
You know how many things are on my to-do list? This is the worst right here. I'm embarrassed to even show you guys this. This is a Typhoon, I guess is the right way to say it, GT on a Sigelli 8W. This juice, which I won't name the vendors, it's not mine, is a grape flavor, has been in here for 8 or 9 months, maybe.
What?
Last time I tried to vape it.
Holy crap, dude! It's gonna get rancid in the tank.
Yeah, no, that one's just like, now it just needs to be dumped and soaked and everything. I can't. That one's past vapable now. So last time I tried it, I was like, oh yeah, that's nasty. that's on the clean out list. This is on the clean out list. This is on the clean out list. This is, you want to talk old school. This is,
man, now you're just making me mad because I've got like two mods out right
here's
now.
Here's my old school stuff, right? This is back in the day stuff. For you old, you know, vapors that have been at it for a while, you might remember this setup. This is Chiyu. Remember that was all the rage. The Chiyu.
Hey, I've got a Chiyu. What are you talking about?
Chiyu with a what the hell you call it, Ithaca clone, which would be Imio. This is the Rainbow Heaven. This wasn't cheap. This was like a $60 tank, actually, and it's a clone. Mm-hmm. And then the Chiyu. It's a nice looking setup. I'm really big on the matching everything. So this is a 23 millimeter setup. So like these two will always be married to each other because they're both 23 millimeter, which is very strange these days. Like
that's everything. Crazy. Everything is 22. My Chiyu with a stealth cap on there.
I do too.
Big band.
I do too.
Yeah, that's what I love about that.
Yeah, there's no air.
I actually was able to get that. That gap because it comes with like the newer ones because I've got the Four Seasons. It comes with like a 2 millimeter gap when we put that stealth cap on there. I said screw it. I went and got my Dremel and a grinding tool and I ground down half the freaking threads on it. Now it's actually fitting flush.
What's up, Rich?
What's up, Rich?
I'm pretending to be Tower of Scope tonight. That's my name. Just
Tower of Scope.
For the next 40 minutes, my name is Tower of Scope, and then I'll just be back to Scope. How do you like the graphics?
That's actually pretty cool. You even got my Darth Maul on there.
That's all Rich.
I know. He threw that on there when I was on the first show. When he was filling in for you, he put that on there. And at first, he went out and found a whole new Darth Maul picture. He's like, all right, I'm going to get Darth Maul on there. And I was like, yeah, you know that picture right there is actually of me wearing a hoodie. He's like, what? That's you? It's like, yeah.
Rich,
we're a TIE fighter today.
Yeah, Rich is helping out the mom, which is the right thing to do. That's awesome.
Oh, rock on.
But I'm trying to, you know, going back to D. Millen's question, I'm still trying to remember, like, the worst thing I ever made. I think one of the ones that I liked the least, I mean, it wasn't my recipe. So I learned, like a lot of people, I started off finding recipes like on ECF and then, buying the ingredients and then mixing them up. And what I found is that some of the ones, this was actually, I learned a lot this way. Actually, I'm kind of glad I did it. Yeah, absolutely, Pammy. Let's do that in one sec. One of the ones I liked the least was, it had like 7 or 8 ingredients, D-Mill, in it. It was like, I forget what it was called, but I just did not like it. It had like cantaloupe and it had a little bit of culotta in it, which it might have been part of why I didn't like
culotta
it.
Culotta or culo?
Culotta.
If it was culo, that's probably why it tasted bad.
Yeah, so if you don't know what culotta is, it's a really interesting additive for mixing that basically makes your mouth feel cold, but it doesn't taste like menthol. So imagine the cold feeling. It makes your mouth feel cold, but it doesn't actually taste menthol-y. It's kind of interesting, and in low doses, it actually can be really good with like a strawberry or watermelon, something like that. If you want to turn it into an iced version, you could kind of simulate the cold feeling that the drink would have. I like it done really, really, really subtle. Like, barely can tell it's there, then it can be really, really effective. If you overdo it, I don't like it at all.
Give away!
Yeah, so let's do that while Rich is here. Maybe we can let Rich actually pick the winner since he's in here.
That's perfect.
That would be really cool to do.
Thursday, our special guest Tower of Vape is going to pick the winner of the next giveaway. If you don't say anything in chat, you forfeit everything.
Saturday.
Monster truck, the biggest you've ever seen.
They run those in Jersey all the time. If anyone lives in Jersey, this English Town Raceway, they that's their commercial, dead on what he just did. And they're like, Saturday at English Town Raceway Park, you know, and they do this whole thing.
Oh, wow. My arms are still jello right now.
All right. Let's see. So... Oh, yeah. That's right on.
No, Tyler. This is giving back for you actually filling in for Scope on the first show. I was supposed to be there while he was kind of crazy. So, hey, man, what goes around comes around. And if you ever need it and we're available, we'll do it for you. Not a problem.
Absolutely, Rich. I was just going to add to that. The whole reason I'm doing this is Rich was gracious enough to cover for me. If you guys remember, my dad came in from LA for a couple of days and their flight was late, and basically they were landing right when my show was supposed to start. And on very short notice, Rich was cool enough to cover my spot. And it happened to be Imah Fokker's first show with me, which I felt horrible about because I was like, Jesus, that guy's first show and I'm not even there. But he ended up doing great, and Rich was great with him. And I thought you guys had a great rapport, so it all worked out in the end. So
I just hope I didn't make Rich laugh too much, because, yeah,
he was rolling pretty good in that show. I don't think he knew what he was getting into with the Fokker.
Hey, I know how to spot him when I see him, and I saw you in Hangouts a few times, and every time you were in Hangouts, you were killing it. And I'm like, why isn't this guy on a show?
And you know what they would ask me every time I'd go into one of those Hangouts? Dude, why don't you have your own show yet?
You were killing it every time.
The chat as soon as it came out. I'll take him as a co-host right now. I claim him.
That's exactly it. I beat everyone to it. I'm like, I'm nailing this. I'm grabbing him because, you know, no one else sees it. I see it. I just knew that. Plus, I get along well with you, and we have similar interests outside of vaping, which makes it even better. So, anyway, okay. So back to that giveaway. Going in order, we were up to Vaping Masters. I actually have had Vaping Masters, and there's one in particular that I had that I really liked. It was a raspberry lemonade, and if anyone knows the name of it in the room, I feel free to type it in for me. I don't think I have the bottle handy. I think I vaped it completely dry, actually, but it was really good. So if you see one that's like a raspberry lemonade, Razade, that's it. Yeah, that was really good. So Razade, I have Razade. Actually been lucky enough to try that one. So it's three winners. So this is a very generous giveaway. Three winners, one 30-mil bottle for each winner.
Okay, while you do this, I will be back. I got to take care of something.
And let's see. And Rich is having us do, we're doing newbie night on this one as well. So we're going to do the same deal. We're only going to pick from people that haven't had Vaping Masters before.
Lou, I don't know if I know him that well.
So, Rich, what we've been doing is just having people answer the Pammy's question. And then, Rich, if you feel up to it, if you want to pick the person, that would be great since this is your show. That'd be, or I should say the pick the three, if I'm reading it right. There's three winners. And then, Pammy, hopefully you can catch them fast enough for the notes. And we'll need the last two of the zip. Yeah, please, like Pammy said, only type your name once or put a one once. Otherwise, it's going to be really hard for them to go through the list. Nice try, Rich. Come on, I'm making you do something. It's your slot. You at least get to pick some winners. Come on. We're going to put you to work. If you're here, you're working. Oh, and he defers it right to Pammy like I did. Nice. Oh, okay. All right. We can twist his arm.
I'll be back.
Oh, and I'll, Rich, you mind if I read the little blurb? So, at Vaping Masters, based out of Florence, South Carolina, Bill and Maxie have a wide variety of devices and e-juices to cater to any customer, no matter if you have never vaped or have been vaping for years. They at Vaping Masters have products to suit your needs. Their staff is always available to share their experiences and expertise to handle any questions you may have, no matter how basic or complex. There are never any stupid questions when it comes to vaping. And Pammy's doing the numbers. When she says stop, then don't type numbers anymore. Okay, so no more numbers. Pammy already put the stop line in. So it's going to be the number closest between when Pammy types start and stop. And since we got three winners, how do you want to do this, Pammy? Do you want to do three closest, or do you want to do two more, pick two more numbers for the other two? I'll let you decide. Three closest. Okay, yeah, that works for me. Yeah, Rich, it's numbers, but the people that put the numbers in are only people that have never tried Vaping Masters. And hopefully you're all being honest, because if you've tried it, Vaping Masters would have a record of that, and then you probably wouldn't get your wins. So, honesty wins. And yes, please don't type anything until we figure out the winners. We're going through the list now. We got two. We found two winners so far. We're just trying to pick out the third one. We might have a tie for third. I don't know. What do you think, Pammy? Okay, yeah, I concur on all those. Oh, so yeah, we did have, that is a tie for the third one. So how do you want to do that? The first one that put it? Or do you want to have those two do a roll-off or something? Do you concur? I concur. Do you concur?
I don't know. Do I?
Do you concur?
I just came back. What do I concur with?
Do you concur? You have to concur.
Are you threatening me?
Are you threatening me?
I need TV for me bunghole.
My bunghole.
All right, so
what did I miss?
Our definite winners are Feeling Groovy and Vaping Trav. And then we have the tie for the third one is tied between Anro and Cranium Vapor. So if one of you doesn't want it by any chance, you can piff and that makes it easy. Or we can do a roll off.
Rolling, 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 keeping going, rolling.
Rawhide.
Oh wait, that's Pammy's duty. I'm sorry. Crack that whip.
Oh, that's cool. Anro just said, "Cranium, you can have it." That was awfully nice.
That's Anro. Awesome, Anro.
That is a community piff right there, if I ever saw one. Right on. That makes it easy.
All right, that was easy.
So the three winners, can I get the last two of your zip? If you can put them all in, hopefully close together. Go! So we can get those for Rich's form. Need the last two of the zip for the three winners.
Feeling Groovy. We got a little bit of a lag. It should come up in a minute.
Yeah, Feeling Groovy, Vaping Trav, and Anro piffed too.
I'm glad I actually found out it was Vaping Trav, because when you first said it, I thought you said Vaping Tran.
And Cranium Vapor. We need the last two of the zip for you, you three. All right, there's Cranium. So we need Feeling Groovy and Vaping Trav.
Hey, do it, Shelly.
That's feeling groovy. So now we just need vaping Trav, last two of the zip.
Feeling groovy. I gotta ask Feeling Groovy if they like Scooby-Doo at all.
Oh, you got them all. Okay. Awesome. Copy paste. Get that in the list.
And thank God CountryPami can actually log in under the regular
Oh yeah, like yesterday that was today. All my stuff.
It's good to see CountryPami instead of CountryPami 2.
I actually have a login for Scope Juice, but I never use it.
Why is that?
I don't know. I just felt like I should have it. Just so somebody else didn't grab it.
This is cool. This is very
they can impersonate me. Yes, congratulations all winners. And we still have more to go. We have Timeless Vapor, and we've got River Bottom Fog Sauce, which I'm dying to try, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'm not much of a tobacco person, but I've heard, like, it's so different than everything else.
There's a couple of tobacco flavors. Like, I totally moved away from tobacco flavors, and then I ended up getting a couple like small bottles and said, oh, okay, I'll drip it and see what's going on. And there's a lot of tobacco flavors that are so light on the tobacco, it's not overpowering. So I will not shy away from tobacco flavors anymore.
Well, if anyone doesn't know about River Bottom, the way it's made just blows my mind. Like, I, even as a juice maker, I look up to this guy like, wow, you know, this guy's a master. Literally all he does is just gets, like, these gourmet tobaccos from all over the place and blends them together. And the only flavoring in the whole thing comes from the actual tobacco itself. And then he does whatever he does to extract the essence of that tobacco into a liquid form to make a juice out of it. So he doesn't add like really any flavors except for the ones that he lists where he says that they're made that way. But the bulk of the line is all naturally extracted tobacco, or net as they call it.
Real tobacco, Raggy.
And from what I hear, this guy's the master at it. And there's a few that I'm really curious to try. I also wanted to explore them for my dad, because when he was here, my dad's kind of like half a vapor, as I like to call him. he vapes, but he still smokes once in a while, which bugs me. And I already lost one parent to cigarettes. I'd like to keep the remaining one not smoking if I can help it.
Hail to the king, baby.
Yeah, and I was, you know, he's definitely still in that phase where it needs to taste like a cigarette to him, or he's not going to be into it. And that's why
when I first started vaping, and
I think it was an
RY4 that kind of got me to the point. It's like, well, it's a little bit like a cigarette, but better. Oh, hey, wait, maybe I should do this. You know.
Yeah, he's still at that point. You know, he hasn't, you know, most of us in the room have had that similar journey where we all start on like tobacco flavors, and then we, you know, a lot of us drift away from tobacco, and, you know, once we find dessert vapes and, you know, drink vapes and things like that. But, you know, my dad hasn't gotten to that point.
Giuliani says it, so he calls Smokey 901 over and yells at the tobacco, and the tobacco extracts itself.
Yeah, that sounds about right, actually. Smokey could do that to you. I tell you, it extracts itself.
You know, that
kind
of reminds me of Ghostbusters 2 when they're yelling at the slime.
Yep.
You disgusting little blob!
But anyway, so what I've heard from people like Vapor Joe and others that this stuff, and Smokey, is that this stuff gets as close as you can get. I'm sorry. Pammy's trying to get my attention. Vaping Trav, we need the last two of... Is that what you were trying to get me to say, Pam?
Yeah. I think I saw him. I don't know if I saw him do it. I saw a bunch of people put some in, but she probably has looked through chat more than I have. So I'd say put it in there again for good measure.
Oh, Pammy, I get it. Pammy, those numbers you those were the winning numbers, not the zip numbers. I get it. Okay, my bad. Yeah, so Baby Trav, we need the last two of the zip.
Gosh, that's bad. I'm coming off a camera to vape because I can't lift my hands up right now.
I hate that feeling. Anyway, so back on River Bottom. So yeah, I sent my dad links to the site, and hopefully he's gonna maybe check it out.
Oh, because he's the tobacco guy?
Yeah, because he's still in that phase. And he wants something that, like, I want him to be just only vape and not smoke at all. And I'm thinking if he got something like River Bottom, from what I hear, it's so damn close that it might be what it... That and a real mod versus the little Sigalikes he's been using, might the combination might be enough to put him over the edge and make him go, okay, yeah, you're right. I don't need cigarettes anymore. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was talking to a couple people who are smoking out at the college I was at today for class, and they, you know, one of them had an ego, and one of them had, like, the Sigalikes, and we're like, yeah, but every time I hit that thing, it just makes me want a cigarette more. Okay, do you have the cigarette like one? It's like, yeah, those kind of made me do that, but I also have that cigar like one. I was like, oh yeah, like the ones that are about that big. She's like, yeah. She's like, but every time I hit that one, it just makes me cough like crazy. And I was like, you know, next time you try it, don't inhale it like a cigarette. I was like, you know, one of the hardest things when you get more power is, you know, you're hitting it like a cigarette, you're gonna get less, you're gonna get more satisfied when you know, hit it like this. And I showed her, and yeah, I don't know. She might end up going back home and trying it out, and you know, start moving away from the cigarettes more. And that's one of the biggest things that I've seen, is because people will come out and, you know, see people with the electronic cigarettes. They'll walk into a gas station or a convenience store, and they'll see one of them sitting there, and it's, you know, a blister pack or something. And hey, let me try that out. But nobody is there to teach them how to actually hit a e-cig versus something else. And I think that's probably one of the biggest deterrents is, you know, somebody hits it like they've been hitting a cigarette, and if you get a, you know, nice powerful vape out of it, it's gonna get you, you know.
Oh yeah. Well, you know, the funny thing is, like, it's kind of sad in a way that the only, you know, if you ask the general public. All right, and yes, pay attention to what Pami just typed. So, Vaping Trav,
Vapor Trav, you have the last 60 two of the seconds zip, to give us the last two digits of your zip code, or we will pip it to somebody else automatically.
Yes, what he said. I used to, I mean, like most people, you know, I thought an e-cigarette was like a blue or, you know, a Sigalike. That's all I thought they were, and I think that most people out there that are still smoking, if you did a survey, I would bet that 90, in the high 90s, I would bet, would only think that Sigalikes were what e-cigarettes were. You know what I mean? Like, they would have no idea that things like this and things like this and things like this, or, you know, things like this exist at all.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, they always look at my mods and like, man, what the hell? That's a huge e-cig, man. Where'd you get that from? I'm a little bit more advanced. but, you know, yeah, as long as you don't try to start off with something like a mech mod, unless you do your due diligence and learn what you need to learn about them. But, yeah, a lot of people, yeah, they'll see that, or even when I have my MVP, you know, I'll take my MVP out every now and then. I've got to start bringing more tanks out when I see people, because they can see what that does a heck of a lot easier than the mech mods that I come out with. Oop, off air.
All right, so Vaping Trav put his last two in, which happens to be
off air.
Which is coincidence then, because that's the same number that was the winning number.
We dropped.
Oh, did we? Oh, shit.
Yeah.
All right.
Or maybe not. I don't know. Drop for me.
I see it kind of stalling. Let's see if I need to... it's moving again.
Yay!
Yay! Do you have Jell-O? Do you have Jell-O? Do you have Jell-O? You ever hear that one?
What?
Do you have Jell-O? Do you have Jell-O? He just keeps saying it over and over to the guy. Crank anchors.
You got Jell-O. That's Jim Florentine. Yeah, he's hilarious.
Is he the one that does the he answers?
He does special ed. He also does the guy that burps all the time.
No, but the ones when the telemarketers call and he answers and tries to keep them on the phone for a long time. That's him. Oh,
yes.
Those are genius.
Yes, I actually have terrorizing telemarketers for.
Oh.
One of the best ones is they kept this girl on the line for, I don't know, it had to have been about a good 15, 20 minutes. Let me transfer you. And they kept transferring to the wrong person except for the one person she wanted.
Oh, yeah,
Oh, hey, wait a minute. Here he is right here.
Yeah. He keeps doing the fake transfer. He puts him on hold, and then he changes his voice.
Yes, it is. Okay, well, I'm calling about... I'm not interested. And hangs up on him.
After like 20 minutes, yeah, it's priceless. You guys got to check that out if you like funny stuff. His voice, too, he gets this like tone to his voice when he's talking to these telemarketers. It's like, you know that dry tone he has?
Yeah.
I can hear it in the back of my head.
Yeah.
he has that way of just messing with them. And like anyone that hates telemarketers would appreciate these recordings.
Jim Florentine and Terrorizing Telemarketers. Okay. Let's see here.
And, I think we're having problems with vapors.tv again.
Oh, yeah?
I don't know. If you're still in the chat, let us know that if the video still looks okay to you.
Yeah, I'm not getting anything.
You're not getting
service
it at all now?
Unavailable. I just tried to refresh.
I'm afraid to refresh. I have chat, but it's moving really slow.
Okay, it's coming back a little bit now. Let's see. Boom! I do have video.
Cop Bitches Brew. I don't know why, but I always laugh when I hear the name
Bitches
of that.
Brew?
Like, you know, I could just picture Pandora going, "What am I going to call this juice?" And he probably looks over at Ego. Was that his intention, or was it more of a Miles Davis, you know, jazz reference? I'm just wondering.
I'm just saying.
I mean, I can actually picture that because I watched the two of you on your show, and I could just picture him. He just made this awesome juice, and he's looking, what am I going to call it? And he just looks. I have to get to the bottom of that one.
Yeah, chat is not working for me. I don't know about anybody else.
It's moving, like, last post I saw was K-Spring, so it's moving slower than normal, which makes me think it's broken.
Yeah, I'm on attempt number 3 right now to reconnect.
Alright, let me try to refresh this so I have an idea what's going on.
Chat go bye-bye!
I'm 2 for 2 this week. I was having problems on Tuesday, too.
You were? No, I think everybody was on Tuesday.
Well,
no, it's you. Either that or it's me. They can't stand the Fokker.
That damn Fokker?
It's that damn Fokker again. Fuck with that one. Shit.
You a pothead Fokker? I love
Puff
that movie.
The Magic Dragon.
That's from, what was that?
Meet the Fokkers.
Yeah, Meet the Fokkers. Or whatever the first one was.
Meet the Fokkers.
Oh, it was Meet the Fokkers, yeah.
No, that was Meet the Parents.
Meet the Parents, that's right. And then I like when they go, her first name's going to be Martha. That means her name's going to be Martha Fokker.
Martha Motherfokker.
Mm. Yeah, my
Wait,
chat's...
you mean to tell me your name is Gay Fokker?
Yeah. Yeah, I love those movies. They're great. Yeah, my chat's completely broken. I've got
Mine
the
too.
Spinning gear of death. Let me just try to refresh. Spinning Gear of Death, Saturday.
Why don't we get everybody to spam Tower of Vapes Facebook page?
Yeah, we might as well. Since they can't type anything here, we might as well get them to go to Rich's page. I would paste it in, but I can't.
Yeah.
So it's facebook.com/Tower of Vape. Real easy to find. So go there and say something nice to Rich. While we're waiting for chat to work, it's gonna make it really hard to give away
anything.
River Bottom Fog Sauce and Timeless. We still have to do.
Who comes on after us?
That is an excellent question. Let me look. I usually know Celtic follows my show or our show now. That would be
I feel so honored that you called it our show.
I can't believe I even asked the question. Obviously, Ego and Pandora.
Ego Mama!
The Giggle Box. Complete with movie shakes and all that goodness.
Ego and Pandora?
Yep. And enough caffeine to choke a mule.
Oh, wow. As long as it's not enough caffeine to choke a goat, we're good. Now, that would be pretty bad.
Pammy and I are chatting because we're apparently the only two people that can chat.
Oh, wow, you're in?
To each other in Skype because there's nowhere else to type.
Hey, I can join that. Hey, you need to give Pammy my Skype information, as a matter of fact.
Oh, yeah, you guys aren't linked up?
No, man. Not in Skype. I've got a couple people in Google Plus, but I really don't have too many people on Skype. I really just started this account.
I wonder if I
really
can.
Really easy to find that one, though, isn't it?
So, Pammy, here it is. It's just like this. Wish I could copy and paste. You can't really in Skype. You can copy and paste messages, but not the actual.
Not the link information. Oh my gosh, this blueberry cream is actually awesome.
And Rich just said whatever giveaways can't be processed during this show, let me know and he'll add it to the late show's queue of giveaways.
Okay.
Give it to Max Mandy to Dolan.
So he's got somebody else doing the late show too.
I guess. My chat is broken. You can't afford
Wait, let's see. I'm on attempt number 10 at this point. By the way, Toxic, both of these are tasting great right now.
Oh, I like this song. Have you heard this?
I don't know. I can't hear it.
It's pretty funny.
I don't know. I play some Richard Cheese every now and then. I don't know. I forgot. Somebody actually was playing some Richard Cheese one time, but he's hilarious.
Yeah, I like Richard
it's
Cheese.
It's ridiculous, man.
One of my favorites, because you know I'm a Slipknot fan.
I can't hear anything in the Hangout. That's the reason why I was asking.
He actually covered People Equal Shit by Slipknot. Richard Cheese does a version of that, which is hilarious.
Yes. what is it? Dawn of the Dead? He does Disturbed and Down with the Sickness.
Yeah, that one's
Gotta get up, come on, get down with the sickness. You fuckers, get up, come on, get down with the sickness.
The best part's the middle part. You know, on the record, the album version that's not edited, he does the whole thing to, like, Mommy or whatever. You stupid, abusive, you know, and he goes on. You want to see how it feels, Mommy? You know, he does that whole part, like, jazz style. That part's really funny.
some people love, one of my favorites is, he's doing Belle Biv DeVoe and Doomy, and they're in the booth, and it's like, I dome in the morning, I dome in the evening, I dome when I want to dome, and the guy clicks in and says, it's Doomy, you know, Belle Biv DeVoe, do,
and oh yeah, and he's
very
like,
big
dome.
In the 90s. Come on, guys.
Yeah.
And Cheese finally is like just sitting there in silence. He's like, well. Fuck you!
He's great. He does it. He has the voice for it, too. I mean, he has that authentic, like, lounge jazz singer voice.
As a matter of fact, some of the stuff he was talking about, he wanted to get into the lounge-style stuff because of Brian Setzer. He ended up seeing, and I actually saw Setzer when he had the 18-piece big band, and don't even go into that, because I love swing music, I wear two-tone wingtips every now and then, so I'm there, but that got him to the point where he wanted to do it, and then he started doing covers, and that's the difference between him. He's not anything like Weird Al or anybody that's doing parodies. He literally does every song verbatim, like it came out on the album. That's why he doesn't have to get, permission to do all this stuff is because it is literally giving everybody, hey, they wrote the song, they sing the song, I am not changing a thing, it's a cover. We're just changing the way the music comes out.
Yeah, just slightly jazzier.
Slightly. You know what it kind of reminds me of? I don't know if anybody's old enough to remember the Bill Murray lounge singer from Saturday Night Live. That's kind of what it reminds me of.
I don't remember that one, but you just made me think of something that is amazing. You got to go look up if you haven't seen it. Now I'm really going to date myself here, but you guys remember Joe Cocker, the singer?
Oh, where he's right next to John Belushi.
Belushi nailed him so good. That has to be one of the best impressions I've ever seen in my life. If you haven't,
they did it side by side when Cocker was. Yeah, that was great.
And Belushi, oh my god, Belushi just knocked it out of the park. I mean, he's dead on Joe Cocker. Joe Cocker in that video. It's one of the greatest things.
It was
ever.
The same era that there was the Bill Murray lounge guy.
Oh yeah. Yeah, there was some the old SNL. It's amazing if you think back to the talent that SNL produced, the stars that came out of SNL. It's just mind-boggling. People like Eddie Murphy. It's like he was on SNL. You know,
I put my toe in the water. Ah, it's hot. Ah, the water's hot.
I actually remember some of Eddie Murphy's stuff on SNL was legendary. I mean, he was really good on SNL even back then.
Working Punub in all the wrong places.
Yep,
working
that one.
Punub.
Yo, aunts, ties, fee times a matey. Buckwheat sings all your hits. Yeah, that one.
But the best part is at the very last one they do, they're doing like all the closing captions at the bottom. And on the very nice one he's singing, it's just question marks, like, we don't know.
Yeah, they just put question mark. I like Mr. Robinson's Neighborhood. Remember that one? Did you ever see that?
Mr. Robinson's Neighborhood?
Yeah, instead of Mr. Rogers, it was Mr. Robinson's Neighborhood. That was so wrong, it was
right. It's like somebody knocking on the door, who is it?
Exactly. The mailman comes with a COD chemistry set. He's like, he just takes it from the mailman and he slams the door in his face. He's like, you know what I just did? I just ripped him off. Can you say ripped him off? You should never play with chemistry sets. Can you say Richard Pryor? I mean, and that was fresh too when he did that. That was messed up.
Oh, damn. He even said fresh.
Yeah.
So fresh, so clean, baby. That's right. Don't be no jive turkey up in here.
Yeah, that one was good. The other one that I remember was and no Pammy, I can't get chat to work either. So we're just riffing. The other one I remember was what was it? That was
Actually, I want to stop you here. We're going to do a squirrel moment because you kept talking about the Jerky Boys. And I have not heard your Jerky Boy impression yet. I don't know if you're going to do Kapow or if you're going to do Frank Rizzo, but I want to hear one.
I fell down the stairs and my shoes fell off.
So Rosenberg.
Get Brett Weir, I said.
Let's see. Well, there's so many different voices from that show.
Yeah, that's what makes it
I went to the top of the Empire State Building and my eyes was going crazy.
Let me think.
You say 3578th Street? I'll be down there with my nub.
When he blows his hands.
It's all numb and stingy.
And then there's the other guy.
911, my cobra, he bit me in the eye. I was supposed to go.
I played wrong too.
He bit me in the eye. I can't see. Please help me.
Yeah, that's the guy. That's the other guy that he does. He's the same guy that does the pizza one. He's like, look at your food.
Store. Check your food. Maybe you poison everybody.
My wife, she's sick. My daughter, she's sick. And all you can talk about is coupon.
He's like, coupon.
If anyone hasn't heard Jerky Boys, you have to do it. There's at least 3 CDs that I know of, probably more. I remember having those because I was in Jersey. We had them as bootlegs, so they were like, if anyone remembers cassettes, They were like, what I mean by generation? They were like 30th, 40th, 50th generation cassettes just you could barely hear with the recording.
Every time you dub off of a copy, it gets a little worse.
Yeah, you add to this.
You get the 50th gen, it sounds like records actually sound good. This just sounded bad.
Yep.
But you could hear enough of it that it made you laugh.
Oh, yeah. Real quick, I remember I used to work years ago in a music store, and we sold everything, like, you know, drums, guitars, basses, and audio gear, right? Like studio monitors and amplifiers and mixing boards and all that stuff. And we were slow one night, and all the employees, we had just gotten a copy of the Jerky Boys on cassette, and we made a rig in the music store. We got out all the gear from our like display racks and put a rack together to like completely ultra optimize this cassette so we could run and make dupes of the Jerky Boys cassette. Like, we ran it through an Aphex oral exciter and a 31 band graphic equalizer and everything we could, you know, trying to scientifically make the best copy we could.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so we went through all of
that. Or do you remember trying to make dub tapes? And it's like you get all the stuff together, I gotta stop recording right now.
I used to do that off vinyl. That's real fun. You hit pause, and then you gotta cue the record, and you try to time it right, and then unpause the cassette.
You're squinting so hard to be able to find that part in between the two songs so I can switch to it.
Yep. Anyway, it's actually 10 o'clock, so we are done, and we still have Broken Chat, so stay tuned for Gigglebox and more Broken Chat. Hopefully they'll get it working soon, but at least you have video. It seems to be working, so you can stay tuned for some Gigglebox.
May the giggles be with you.
Always. I am your father.
No!
I want to thank everyone for coming out and supporting me and Fokker covering for Rich. Sorry we didn't get to the last two.
For everybody since they can't chat. Everybody for sticking around. Fist
yes, brofist for sticking around. I can see that you're still here even though I can't chat with you. And Rich just typed in our Skype. He said thank you Scope and thank you Imah Fokker. So he thanks everybody as well. And that is all I have for now. So we'll catch you later.